Welcome to episode 11 of our Galatasaray Rebuild. Last time we left off at the end of December in our second season. We'd recovered from a bit of a poor start in the league to win our last nine games in a row, and that's led us to being 10 points clear at the halfway stage. Although coming up in this episode, we do have a tough game against Trabzonspor, which we'll need to win just to make sure we keep out front in the league. We also managed to qualify from a pretty tough group in the Champions League, which included Juventus and Liverpool, which then saw us drawn against Man United in the first round of the knockouts, and we'll see the first leg of that in this episode as well. So without further ado, let's get going. Since the turn of the year, we've been able to keep our good run of form going. The next game, obviously, is the game against Trabzonspor, which we'll see in a second. Going into that game, we're 17 points clear at the top of the table, which, considering at one point in the first half of the season, we were 5 points off the top and really kind of struggling. A lot of that, obviously, is down to the fact that we've won our last 14 games in a row. We've gone 22 games without losing. Looking at the league, the games we've had in January and February, fairly comfortable wins, 4-1, 3-1, 2-0, 6-1. For some reason, we always seem to be able to turn it on against Konyaspor. We beat them in a couple of games, big games last season. We beat them in the Turkish Cup final. We beat them in the Super Cup this season as well. So we just seem to be able to score goals no matter what against them. Last league game, we won against Sivasspor 3-1. We struggled a bit in that one once they pulled it back to 1-1 to before we went ahead. Also, since the beginning of January, we've played a couple of cup games. The first game against Karsuyaka, we played a fully rotated team. In fact, in the second half, both of our goalkeepers had spells out on the right wing. Just because we were really just wanting to rest our senior players. Obviously, they had the break coming up anyway, but just rest the first team players. We won 11-0, comfortable victory. Four goals for Imam Ali Bilia, who was one of our youth intake last season, who's doing well, particularly coming off the bench, but he scored four goals in that cup game. And then the last cup game, because there was a short turnaround between the Trabzonspor game, before the Trabzonspor game, we again rotated the team, played a mostly second choice team. The only exception was we brought Sacha Bowie on for 45 minutes in the second half, just because he's coming back from injury and we need to get some minutes into him before that Man United game at the end of the month in the first leg of the first knockout round. But we'll be back in a second with the Trabzonspor game. Okay, going into the game against Trabzonspor, we've got pretty much the strongest team that we can pick. Alperzan's in instead of Victor Nelson, who's been out injured. We've brought Sacha Bowie back in. Kerem Aktürkoğlu's been injured as well, not fit enough to start, so Dervişoğlu's starting. And that's it. So, I mean, hopefully we're 17 points clear of Trabzonspor. Beşiktaş won, so it's 15 points clear at the top. I think we just need to go in and just keep doing what we've been doing. Hopefully the squad's too strong for Trabzonspor, and we'll get started. Let's just give them a quick encourage to get them started there. It's not looking too... Oh, that's okay. Right, I need to press, force a mistake. Right, now we need to just turn it the other way and get to the byline. No. Right. Oof. Welcome back to Sasha. First goal of the season for him. Lovely looking finish, that one. Outside of the right foot, bent into the bottom corner. What are they? Not sure why we saw a VAR. Bearing in mind the ball was passed backwards. Right, I mean, they've had a lot of the ball, but obviously nowhere really near enough to be able to create any chances. Having said that, they're going to score here, aren't they? Oof. Thought I'd put the massive kiss of death on that one. Right. What a pass. That's a bit loose. How have we not scored? Let's hope we don't come to regret chances like that. I mean, we've not played particularly well. I wonder if I think what I'm going to do is swap Dervsoglu to the left and bring on Kerem. And at some point in the second half, we'll probably take Sasha off at right back, and just so we don't risk him picking up another injury. So unusual thing is, so far Lorenzo Luca hasn't looked like winning a header. Let's hope that works. Oh no, what the hell was that corner all about? That's definitely not what we're supposed to be doing. So I think what we'll do is we'll replace both fullbacks, seeing as Van Aanholt's injured. So anyone else? And I think what we'll do is we'll make a change at centre half as well, just because of how fatigued Alphazan looks. Had all the time in the world, and that's the best he could do. But at least he's finally won a header. Right. Now, can we break? What was that flick all about? Right. Little no look flick to keep the move going. Surely that looked, well, it looked offside. And that did not look like a penalty. It's another one of these penalties that it looks like the guy completely clearly won the ball. I mean, I'd rather it had been given, but, you know. And he's given this one. Right, can we just wrap it up, make it comfortable? That's it. 2-0. That should put us, I think, 18 points clear at the top now. I think it's going to require a disaster of monumental proportions for us not to win the league from here. What a save. Let's just see the game out. There's 4.5 minutes of injury time left. Don't do anything stupid. Not exactly a brilliant performance, although, I mean, we did pick it up a bit in the second half with the chances we had. I mean, all you can ask for is to keep the winning run going. We are, like I say, it's going to take a disaster of monumental proportions for us to throw away this title from here. So we're 18 points clear of Besiktas with 13 games left. I mean, really, if we don't win the title from here, I think I should be resigning before they even have a chance to sack me. But that hopefully now allows us to focus on the Champions League. So we've got a really tough first leg coming up against Manchester United, and we'll be back in a second for that game. It's time for the first leg of the Champions League game against Manchester United. Going into that game, we're slightly disappointed because our run of winning games has ended, because we drew 3-3 with Hatayspor. We were 3-2 up at half time, conceded one second half, and just couldn't do anything to make it 3-3. Going into the game against Man United, obviously we're missing Patrick Van Aanholt, who got injured in the game against Trabzonspor, dislocated shoulder, so he's out for a couple of months. And Victor Nelson is not fit enough to play more than 45 minutes, so Adil Pazan continues in the centre of defence. We've brought kept Sacha Boey in at right back because he's now back to fitness. But otherwise, that's pretty much a full strength team for us. Obviously, looking at that Man United team, I mean, it could probably be stronger when you look at the players on the bench. So hopefully we can kind of catch them on an off day. It's going to be a tough game, and we just need to do something in this first home leg before we go to Old Trafford at the end of March for the second leg. That was a bit of a scary start, considering we didn't seem to get anywhere close to the ball in the first 15 seconds when they had it. But can we create a chance? Oh, that would have been a brilliant start. Oh, first 6 minutes we hit the post and the bar. Oh. It's one of those games where we're going to create a load of chances and not take any of them and really regret it, I think, isn't it? Oh, we'll take that Bruno Fernandes red card. That'll do nicely. Right, can we shoot? Oh, what was that? Managed to pick up absolutely no one there apart from the goalkeeper. Right. The ball into the box. Just give them the ball and let them counter-attack. And given that the change in formation they've made, with the sacrifice of a wide player to bring someone in centre midfield, hopefully our wing backs going forward with the inside forwards can kind of create an overload on the on their full backs. We've hit the bar again. I mean, we should have two. And it's 0-0 against 10 men. The one player that we have that always seems to turn up to call out is nervous. Right. We've got some tired players who aren't playing particularly well. Right, let's take Turic off and stick Akgun on. And Luca looks knackered as well. I mean, obviously we're losing a lot of height there, so hopefully don't come to regret that. Get the ball in the box. Yes! It's one of the subs popping up there with a goal. This is kind of what we have missed with Sasha being injured at right wing back. The replacements that we've had haven't really had the same drive forward. I think Chicaldo, with him being booked and Bonnie and knackered, will take him off. We don't really have much options at left back with Van Aanholt out injured. Oh, he instantly scored again. Brought Ronaldo on. Oof. That was close. Another red card. Oh, if we can nick another goal while they're down to 9. Post again. I mean, if we could nick another goal now while we're down to 9 with them going in with a couple who are suspended for the second leg, that would be great. But really, it's important that we don't just concede. I mean, we should have had 4 or 5 in this game. Eunice has scored again. It's twice. It's unwelcome off the bench. He might force his way into the team for the next game. So 2-0 up, going to second leg. Two players suspended, but one of them is Bruno Fernandes as well. We've got a chance. I would still say they're favourites going into that second leg, but, you know. Did they end up? Ended up with Cristiano Ronaldo playing the centre midfield. It's an interesting way of doing things. But, you know, 2-0 up. Good. We played well. We hit the post and the bar so many times. We could add 4 or 5. But we'll take 2-0, especially with their sendings off and the suspensions that they're going to have for the second leg. And join us in the next episode when we'll have the second leg of the Man United game. There's a big game against Fenerbahce, and we'll also have a youth intake day. We'll see you then.